on. And out in the tropics, things getting a little active. It's June and we're tracking the main development region. That is the area way out in the Atlantic. This is usually what we watch in August and September, but we got two areas. This is our first one. This is Invest 95, not very organized. It's moving fast, 22 miles an hour to the west. Usually these things moving that fast, they don't organize that much because they're moving too fast, too much shear. But it might try to organize some as it gets towards the Caribbean. It's going to get to the Lesser Antilles here by tomorrow night. Thursday, Friday, just kind of hanging out somewhere in here, but the development chances about a 40% right now. We'll watch it long term, but right now it doesn't look like it's going to be an issue for the Gulf. That's how it looks right now. Now behind that, you notice there's kind of this tail of moisture. This is attached to a broader area of circulation. Models are a little bit more aggressive with this area of showers and thunderstorms, and the National Hurricane Center highlighting this one kind of long term. Probably not going to do anything over the next couple of days, but by, you know, 5, 6, 7 days out, it's going to be in this part of the Caribbean, and we'll keep an eye on it, make sure it doesn't try to sneak up into the southern Gulf. A week to a week and a half away. That's a long time, and we're not going to sit here and speculate. I'm certainly not going to show you any of the models. That's just not good meteorology, but we'll keep an eye on it long term. It's hurricane season after all. Typically down here, it's quite rare to get something to spin up this time of year. It's usually too hostile with wind shear and dry air, but you know, it can certainly happen. So we'll be watching that one long term. It is not an immediate threat to the Gulf though. All right, the next name, we're through the D storm. Elsa is our next name. We'll see who gets that. And then after that, Fred, Grace, and so on and so forth. Hopefully we don't meet any of those. Our forecast.